Rocket Chat. So Rocket Chat is a popular chat application that a lot of private chat that a lot of enterprises are using. So it has many, many thousands, like 800,000, I think, users, something like it's very, very popular. So the problem that they had was that for accounts that didn't have multi-factor authentication, researchers found a way to get the password reset token for the account. Then they could log in for as that account. For admin accounts, even those that had two-factor authentication, they could then extract email, password hash, and two-factor authentication secret, second-factor authentication secret, log in as that admin, and then take over the account and execute any code on that user behalf. So the way that that happened is that the MongoDB is a database used behind the scenes to power the application, and researchers found a way in the parameters of the API calls to supply, instead of the regular stream that the API expected, to supply NoSQL injections. And that was because the application did have some protection. So the application code was verifying that they were not getting SQL injection, but MongoDB is a very powerful, has a very powerful language. And so researchers found some expressions that were not blocked by those checks. So basically in the code was checking that these particular expressions were not used, but researchers just found different expressions. For example, they could supply something like that. The where clause was not, and the where expression was not blocked. And so they could supply something like that, that would throw, that would get information within the Mongo. And for example, in that case, it's an uncaught exception. And you can see that this actually throws the secret of that user. And that's how the data are leaked. So I would say it's a broken authentication and excessive data exposure. Again, strictly define and enforce all your API inputs. It's for any stream, I mean, define any data types. If it's a stream, define the exact regular expression of what is allowed. If it's alphanumeric only, then so be it. Define that whatever it's from 1 to 20 characters and has only alphanumeric characters, something like that. Define outputs as well, right? So if your API does leak data, that can get prevented because that's an unexpected output. And again, block lists don't work well. I use allow list. So only allow the stuff that you expect, and everything else needs to be blocked. Obviously, two-factor authentication is a good idea on our accounts.